Good morning. Glad to be with you again. Father Mike Baim, happy to celebrate and fill in today for Father Ed. So why don't we begin in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. We come together and we do it as God's family, mindful that God is with us, and we celebrate the gifts of his love and mercy once again.
Lord Jesus, let your name burn in our hearts. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, thy will be done. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, show us our crosses. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. God of might, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. You duped me, O Lord, and I let myself be duped. You were too strong for me, and you triumphed. All the day I am an object of laughter. Everyone mocks me. Whenever I speak, I must cry out. Violence and outrage is my message. The word of the Lord has brought me derision and reproach all the day. I say to myself, I will not mention him. I will speak in his name no more. But then it becomes like fire burning in my heart, imprisoned in my bones. I grow weary holding it in. I cannot endure it. The word of the Lord.
My soul is thirsting for you. Flesh pines and my soul thirsts, like the earth parched, lifeless and without water. Have I gazed toward you in the sanctuary to see your power and your glory? For your kindness is a greater good than life. My lips shall glorify you. Thus will I bless you while I live. Lifting up my hands, I will call upon your name. As with the riches of a banquet shall my soul be satisfied, and with exultant lips my mouth shall praise you. Shadow of your wings, I shout for joy. My soul clings fast to you. Your right hand upholds me.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. I urge you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, your spiritual worship. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and pleasing and perfect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Jesus Christ, enlighten the eyes of our hearts, that we may know what is the hope that belongs to us all.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer greatly from the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed on the third day, and on the third day be raised. Then Peter took Jesus aside and began to rebuke him. God forbid, Lord, no such thing shall ever happen to you. He turned and said to Peter, Get behind me, Satan. You are an obstacle to me. You are thinking not as God does, but as human beings do. Then Jesus said to his disciples, Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? Or what can one give in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man will come with his angels in his Father's glory, and then he will repay all according to his conduct. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Good morning, once again. So nice to be with you and to celebrate in this beautiful, beautiful church. I never grow tired of looking at this place. It's great. Just want to say a word of welcome back to Ben Roth, our seminarian here from St. Genevieve. He's kind of fresh at it. And Ben, we're glad that you're here today to celebrate with us for your free weekend. He said the Latin is pretty tough. So say a prayer for him as he learns his Latin. His mom and dad, I understand, are right here. So good morning and welcome. Ben asked me to put in a plug for that new truck for you guys. So if you can, you know, come across with that, that'd be great. Well, we celebrate today as we continue on, you know, throughout ordinary time. This is the 22nd Sunday. And we hear some readings today. They're pretty interesting, I must say. You know, the word gospel means good news. And after hearing these readings, we might think, yeah, but not so much today. In that first reading, Jeremiah is in a very tough spot. God called him to be a prophet, and he sent him to speak a message that nobody wanted to hear, that challenged the people of Israel on every level of who they were. And as a result, he feels like God duped him. God tricked him into doing this, and he ruined his life. And then in the gospel, we see the disciples get that very hard news that Jesus, the one that they thought would save the world, the one who had the power to perform nature-defying miracles of healing and feeding and so on, that this Jesus is going to have to suffer and be killed at the hands of others. No wonder Peter said what he said. God forbid, Lord, nothing should ever happen to you. And then Jesus goes on, and he goes on to tell them that they too will have to suffer. They're going to have to carry their own crosses. They're going to have to deny themselves. They're going to have to lose control. Eventually, they're going to lose their lives. Jeremiah, Jesus, and the disciples were proclaiming a message in a world that was hostile to their message. But they did it not without a promise.
Jeremiah felt a great draw to this. He felt this tugging of his heart that he had to do it, even though it was difficult. And then he found in it a sense of fulfillment in keeping on doing what God had called him to do. It's a great story. The disciples, they hear Jesus' promise that even though they will carry their crosses, that the crosses will lead to life. Interesting, isn't it? And we know that story from our perspective in history. We know the paradox that when we give up something, we receive even more. So when we carry a cross, we know that that cross doesn't just lead to death because it didn't for Jesus. That it opened the gates to eternal life, to that resurrection, to that great hope. So it's always good, I think, to think about this in our own context of history. And I'd like us to consider, you know, this message today that we get for our own time, for our own circumstances. And we know that it's difficult today, just as it was then, to share the truths and the beliefs of our faith. Think about the opposition that's out there. Think about the opposition out there when we speak of things like the value of life and the need to protect the most vulnerable from abortion or assisted suicide and the like. Think of the opposition that's out there when we speak about the dignity of every human person, about the gift that each person is, no matter where they come from or no matter what they look like. And how we speak of the need to respect all people, even those who are different from us. Think of the opposition when we speak of the need to do our best to grow in chastity and faithfulness and to steer away from reckless behavior or of taking advantage of others for my own pleasure or my own benefit. Think of the opposition when we talk about the beauty of sharing our resources to help our church, or welcome the stranger, or live with a heart that's full of charity and service rather than selfishness. We know that these messages don't always get welcomed into people's hearts. We know that it can be tough. We know that we can be ignored and even mocked. We know that it's easy to despair and give up, to think that those who oppose us don't deserve to hear our message. It's easy to not even bother. But back to the readings. We are, like Jeremiah and the disciples, called by Jesus himself to do this mission, to speak courageously, and also receive the same promise and hopefully feel that same burning desire to do it, or at least to grow in that desire. You know, Pope Francis, you probably heard this, has spoken a lot about how we are called to be missionary disciples. It's a great term, and it's a great mission for statement for each one of us. That to be a missionary disciple, to go out to serve in Jesus' name, to speak the truth in love, to invite others to faith, to walk with others along that journey, maybe even inspire them by our words, but more importantly, by our examples. And always remember that we do that in the name of Jesus, that we must always show that message, that we share that message with our kindness and our patience and our understanding. But first, before we go out on mission, it's so important that we be in touch with the Lord, to know that he's with us and to know how deeply he loves us and to how much he fills us with his mercy and his compassion. This Eucharist that we celebrate is a sure sign of God renewing his love for us as he comes to give us the gift of his very self as we eat and drink of his body and blood once again in Mass today, even though we don't always deserve it. Think about that. God gives to us freely. Our job is to imitate that kind of commitment toward others, and to give what we can, to do what we can for the good of the people around us. So today, and maybe this week, let's pray for ourselves and pray for each other, to grow in our faith, to heed the call to be courageous and patient and kind as we deliver in word and deed Jesus' message of love and service, of faithfulness and sacrifice. Let his fire of love burn in our hearts and move us to invite others to a deeper faith. Let us always remember that any cross we carry will lead to the hope of resurrection and the promise of fulfillment and life. What a great invitation we get today. Let's ask the Lord to open our hearts to that and ask the Lord to give us the words that we need to share with others that same love and mercy that he first shares with each of us.
And together let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And now let us offer our petitions to our loving God.
For Pope Francis and all the bishops and clergy, that they may be given the wisdom, strength, and courage to guide the faithful through the challenges of our times. Let us pray to the Lord. For the grace to follow Christ, that we may embrace the cross as we experience opposition, hardship, or rejection, and allow God to raise us to new life. Let us pray to the Lord. For the gift of discernment, that the Holy Spirit will guide us in recognizing the voice of God that comes to us in our prayer, reflection, and life experiences. Let us pray to the Lord. That God may bless and make fruitful the efforts of all who labor to support the financial needs of their families, and for the unemployed having difficulty seeking employment. Let us pray to the Lord. For the residents of Texas and Louisiana who were affected or displaced by Hurricane Harvey, that they may know our Heavenly Father's consolation and compassion in and through the many people reaching out to them physically and financially. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who are traveling during this holiday weekend, that God may bless all with safety and rest. Let us pray to the Lord. For our brothers and sisters beset by illness, especially those with long-term or terminal illness, that the presence of Christ may give them the strength they need to carry these painful crosses. Let us pray to the Lord. For our brothers and sisters who have died, that through the mercy of God, they may rest from their labors in the divine presence forever. Let us pray to the Lord. And for all those special prayers and intentions we hold in our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, we come before you with thanks and in faith. We ask you now to hear us as we pray. Help us to know of your presence and to grow in your love and your peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Archbishop Robert Carlson has asked that all parishes in the Archdiocese take up a second collection today to help our brothers and sisters in the South who are experiencing the aftermath of Hurricane Harvey. Funds raised will go directly to Catholic relief efforts via Catholic Charities of St. Louis. If you are not prepared to make a donation today and would like to still donate, please place your gift in an envelope marked Hurricane Relief and place it in next week's collection. The need for the people in Texas and Louisiana is enormous. Thank you for your generosity. As our gifts are prepared, let us sing number 550 in the Glory and Praise hymnal, number 550.
Let us pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, for in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the paschal mystery. And so, with all the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration, we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Genevieve and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth. with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you in our neighbor. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
In your kindness, please pray for the repose of the soul of Glenwood Stretch, whose funeral service was this past week. Next Saturday, September 9th, the 5 p.m. Mass will be changed to 4 p.m. due to the parish picnic. Please come out to support our parish picnic next weekend. Additional help is always appreciated. Please call the parish office if you would like to help in any way. In commemoration of the 5th anniversary of the National Day of Remembrance, on Saturday, September 9th, at 9 a.m. in front of the statue for the unborn on the side of church, there will be a recitation of the rosary for all who have been affected by abortion. Our recessional hymn is number 726 in the Glory and Praise hymnal, America, number 726.
So nice to be with you all today. I hope you enjoy the rest of your Labor Day weekend. Hope you get to enjoy it with family and friends. Have a great day ahead and a good week. The Lord be with you. May God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.